She helped herself along with a stick, and it is difficult to say how she moved, for she stumbled and limped, rolled along almost as though her legs were broken down wheels, which would soon give way. The cobbler's wife stared hard at her, for although she had been sitting in the marketplace every day for the last 16 years, she had never noticed the queer old creature before. But she shuddered involuntarily when the old woman hobbled towards her and stood still before the baskets.
"Are you Hannah, the vegetable dealer?"
she said in a cracked, unpleasant voice, her head shaking as though with palsy. "Yes, that is my name," replied the cobbler's wife. "Is there anything I can serve you with?"
I must see, she replied. "Let me look at your herbs and see if you have anything I require."
She plunged her brown, skinny fingers into the basket of herbs which had been so neatly set out, and, grasping handful after handful, put them to her long, hooked nose and smelt them. The cobbler's wife was much put out to see her rare herbs handled in this way, but she did not like to say anything, for it was the customer's right to examine the goods, and besides, she was half afraid of the old woman. When the whole of the basket of herbs had been handled and turned over, the old woman muttered, "Rubbish, rubbish, the whole lot of it. 50 years ago I could have bought what I wanted. This is good for nothing." These words angered little Jakob.
"You are a rude old woman," he said angrily. "First you take up our beautiful fresh herbs in your nasty fingers and crush them. Then you put them to your long hooked nose so that nobody else who had seen you would want to buy them. And then you miscall our wares as bad stuff and rubbish, when even the Duke's cook does not disdain to buy from us."